Let's talk about character stitches and decorative stitches on our machine. And I apologize for the moire that's showing up on this video. Hopefully you'll be able to see everything okay. If you go into your sewing mode and select the tab that shows character decorative stitch, you'll see that there are six categories of decorative stitches on the machine, and then there are some alphabetic characters, and down at the bottom you have the ability to create your own stitch and recall that stitch. We'll focus on the six characters right now and the alphabetic characters, and let's look at the screen and understand what each of these icons mean. On the right hand side, the first icon puts your machine in a free motion mode. The second takes a pattern to the beginning of a stitch. So if you're sewing out a stitch and you realize that it's wrong and you want to get to the beginning of the pattern, you'll select the second icon. The third icon allows you to see what the pattern will look like if it's stitched out in a continuous mode or with a singular stitch. The fourth icon is to mirror image horizontally, and the next icon is a mirror image vertically, meaning top to bottom. The next icon, L and S, and some of the stitches you have the ability to change from large to small. When you're creating combination stitches, you have the ability to delete a stitch at a time. But if you want to go in and edit moving between stitches and that, it's best to save sections of the stitch and to retrieve them so that you can edit them, because you do not have the ability to move to the beginning and the end. And I'll show you that as we're working. The next icon is grayed out, but it functions in some of the menus for stitches, such as category 9, and the next icon is for the sensor pin. Let's go into category 6, and let's select a stitch, and as I mentioned earlier, the width, length, and left, right, shift is grayed out. If I select a singular stitch and choose that same stitch again, I can choose the small version of that stitch, and I know that it's selected because the S is brown or brownish color on my screen, and the same is true for the singular stitch. To see what this will look like stitched out, I can select the pattern repeat, and I can now see what this will look like when I sew it out. If I want to save it into my memory pocket, I can do so by selecting either the memory pocket or a USB stick or direct connection with my machine. I have already saved it previously, so I won't save it right now. If I want to look at a larger image of it, I can see that on the screen, and I can also change the color of thread to see what it would look like. If I choose the plus sign, it zooms in, and the minus zooms out. If you notice at the top of the screen that the foot that is recommended is the end foot, and I have the end foot right now on my machine. Let me show it to you. This foot, unlike the J foot, it has a large tunnel on the back of the foot, so that as stitches are being stitched out, the buildup of stitches will move through that tunnel and won't jam up your machine. Now let's look at some other stitches and talk about some of the functions. If you notice, because I added another stitch, it kept the combination I had created first, and it's added another stitch to it. And right now, because that is light blue, that is the stitch that is selected. Now on this particular pattern, I can either mirror image horizontally or vertically, Let me do horizontal, and you can see what that looks like. And I can also mirror image vertically. And now you know that those are selected because they are a dark brown. And let's go ahead and save that combination into memory. And I saved it into the memory pocket. If I wanted to add additional stitches to this combination, I can go into other categories and I can add another stitch, such as this little ball, which is a satin ball. One of the things you notice in this stitch is that the satin stitches in category 8, you can change the density. So I can make it to where it is more dense or more of a satin stitch, or less dense, more like a sewing machine stitch or zigzag. And I'll leave it as more dense for right now. If I choose to go into another menu to add a stitch, I want to make sure that I use return rather than touching the character decorative stitch menu, because it will delete that pattern. So I would choose return. I can go back and choose whatever stitch pattern I want to add. And now I have created another combination. And so this is what this combination would look like sewn out. If I decide I no longer want to use this combination, all I have to do is I can either delete one stitch at a time, and you'll notice that in succession each stitch has been deleted. If I go back to the character decorative stitch menu and retrieve a particular stitch, and let's choose one that I had saved earlier. Now what I can do is select the retrieve icon to open it up on my screen. At this point, I can go ahead and sew this, or I can make changes to it by pressing delete. If I wanted to save this pattern, I could do the same thing and save it back to the memory pocket. We've talked about category 6, and in category 7, the stitches, you have the ability to change the width, length, and left, right, shift, but you can't change it between large and small. If we go into category 8, as I mentioned earlier, we have the ability to change the density. One of the things that we also have the ability to do in multiple categories is to add a step. And what this does is it shifts the stitches that you're adding to the right or to the left based upon the selection of this, and it is a half stitch wide. So if you look at this stitched out, this is what it would look like. And obviously it is going over to the right. So what you would want to do is you would want to create some stitches moving back to the left so that your stitch pattern would be straight. And you can see what that looks like. Let's delete this by moving from the menu. And category 9, I mentioned earlier that these are satin stitches. You have the ability to elongate these stitches. So let me put a singular stitch. So you can see that I have a long stitch here. And if I want to add another stitch and make it a short stitch, all I do is select this icon and choose a number between 1 and 5, which affects the size of that stitch. We'll go back and to category 10. These are our cross stitches. With the cross stitches, you do not have the ability to change the width, the length, or left, right, shift. We'll go back into category 11. Category 11 are our utility stitches, where we have the ability to create a combination with the utility stitches. And we can also go into any of the other categories to create a unique look. Let's return. If you go into the character stitches, you have the ability to change the upper, lowercase, and you can select numbers, special characters, and even accents for foreign languages. My given name is Therese, so I can choose the E, and the lowercase E with that accent. And that's right here. And go back to the lowercase regular letters. And I've spelled my name. And again, if I want to save that, all I have to do is save it into my memory pocket, either on a USB, my machine, or to my computer. One thing that's unique with the character stitches that are fonts is the ability to change the spacing. Now, this affects everything in the combination as far as an alphabetic character. So it will, you cannot make the changes to just a few of the letters. If you want to add a space between what you have on the screen, you can select this icon. And now if I wanted to spell my last name, I can do that. And the thing I like about sewing out some of these stitches is that I can sew these on ribbons, or I can create some fast quilt labels, but you can also do it in the embroidery. Let's save that to the memory pocket, and I'll show you how we retrieve things from the memory pocket. We'll go back to the character decorative stitches, and if you notice, you have an icon here to retrieve things that have been saved in the memory pocket. And this is one that I saved earlier where I have my name as well. In order to retrieve this so that you can stitch it out, you need to select this icon. And when you do that, you have the ability to stitch this out on the screen. You also have the ability to delete characters or make changes to it. For instance, if you wanted to go ahead and add a decorative stitch to the end of it, you could do that. I'll choose delete and return. So this basically covers everything that is in the decorative stitches. We talked about the icons over here in the first segment when we were talking about some basic sewing. And as I mentioned earlier, I will cover the topics of how to create my own stitch here in another video.